James Bond has been an icon for 59 years now for many people. He is the super spy that we all know and love, who dispatches campy villains while delivering iconic one-liners. Bond always has the best gadgets, and among them in every single movie is his watch. In No Time to Die, Bond will be wearing his new Omega Seamaster that has been designed closely with Daniel Craig and the James Bond filmmakers. It reflects the experience that Daniel has had as 007. It is actually a homage to the original Rolex worn by Sean Connery in Dr. No, which was the first Bond movie ever. And the idea of this being an Omega watch, it commemorates Daniel Craig's last movie, but not James Bond's last, hopefully. This watch is not just a fluffy homage variation of the Seamaster, though. It is totally unique. And today we are going to explain why this watch is worthy to be worn by a super spy, and of course, all super spy fans. What's up, everyone? It's Chris with the Little Treasury Channel. Welcome back. This is where we bring you awesome watch content at least once a week. If you haven't already, please make sure to smash that subscribe button and hit the notification bell to be alerted as soon as we upload. I'm from Little Treasury Jewelers, which is located in Gambrels, Maryland. And it's where you go when you're in the know. As always, the watches that I review are for sale and can be purchased, so please see the description below to contact us. In our last video, we reviewed the new G-Shock Metal Casio pieces, which at a super low price point with a high value are a necessity for every human to have. And I found that the difficult part is just figuring out which color to choose. Wrist check time. This is a James Bond video, so I'm wearing my blue dial Seamaster Professional. And if you are familiar with the history of these pieces, the first Seamaster Professional was launched with GoldenEye in 1995, and Pierce Brosnan had a laser on his that he used to cut his way out of the bottom of a train and escape a trap. I bought the blue version because this is the original version, and I'm a huge James Bond fan. By the way, when this first came out, I did a more colorful video on this piece, which was actually demonetized. And if you want to laugh, check out the link in the description below. Now, tell me which watch you're wearing while you're watching the video, and make sure to tell me why. Now, let's get on to the features. The 007 Edition Seamaster has a 42.1mm case width, a 12.7mm thickness, a 49.3mm lug-to-lug, a 19.8mm lug width, and weighs in at 97.72 grams. The case is made out of grade 2 titanium, which is capable of withstanding extreme temperatures, and is used in pieces that are suitable for space exploration. It is completely brushed and has a dim gray color. The helium escape valve can be found on the left side, and is a staple of the Seamaster, although it can only be used to decompress the watch inside of a pressure chamber. A screw-down crown with the Omega logo can be found at the 3 position. The crystal is domed, but made out of sapphire, and provides a distortion to the edges. The bezel is made out of aluminium, which was used in order to get that tropical brown color and vintage look that Omega was after, and also has vintage loomed numerals. But does this bezel give clicks that are worthy of James Bond? Oh yeah, this bezel's worthy, and it sounds just like the RCP90. Yeah, true Bond fans will know what I mean by that. Holding it up next to my blue Seamaster shows that the 007 is a lot more subdued and completely matte in comparison. Most importantly, the Bond is about a half millimeter thinner. The dial is made out of aluminum and is tropical brown to match the bezel, with a minute grade along the edge in the vintage cream color. The indices consist of two rectangles at the 12, a single rectangle for the 3, 6, and 9, and circles for the rest. They all have the vintage cream color loom, and blackened frames. Omega, the logo, and Professional can be found at the top middle portion in vintage cream, and Seamaster can be found in red. The hour and minute hands are sword style and have been blackened, and more vintage cream color can be found on them as well. The second hand is also blackened and has a red tip and a round vintage cream area. Co-Axial Master Chronometer 300m/1000ft can be found at the bottom middle portion in vintage cream, and below it you will find the broad arrow symbol. which indicates that this piece has been issued by the British government. Lume can be found on all indices, every single mark on the bezel, and has a blue on the hour hand with a green on the minute hand, and also a green pip at the 12 on the bezel. The case back is closed, and you will find a series of numbers in the genuine format for a military issue watch. The 0552 signifies a naval code. The 923-7697 meaning a diver's watch. The A meaning a screw-down crown. 007 is obvious, and 62 is the year of the first James Bond film, Dr. No. The 007 logo can be found at the bottom, and this is the only place that you will find 007 on the watch. The case back also has the NIAD lock, which means that it will always close to the exact same position where it was opened after service. The movement is Omega's Co-Axial 8806 caliber, which is the no-date version of the 8800, and is META certified to be 0 to 5 seconds a day in accuracy, has a 55-hour power reserve, is anti-magnetic to 15,000 Gauss, or an MRI machine, and beats at 25,200 beats per hour. The coaxial escapement will give this piece a 6 to 8 year recommended service interval. The bracelet is unique to this watch and is a mesh link style in grade 2 titanium. However, it functions just like a strap with a deployant buckle and has holes built into it, so no need to take out any links or have micro adjusts. The deployant buckle has the Omega logo on it and it's also titanium. This watch also comes in a NATO strap version with a striped color scheme. The 007 Edition Seamaster has a 300 meter water resistant and is ready to help your Christmas come quickly this year for a wonderful $9,200. Now for my humble opinion. This one is super light and it's all matte and it's simple and clean, but it's sophisticated. I really love it personally. After wearing it for a bit on the bracelet, I realized that this bracelet can be scrunched a bit to achieve a super comfortable fit and kind of strangely poofs out a bit before adjusting it. It looks fantastic and slim on my 6.5-inch wrist. I think that the way that they made this bracelet just like a strap is very innovative and saves the headache of hearing about pin and collars on a titanium bracelet. This does have the helium escape valve on it, which I hear mixed opinions on all the time, but I feel that it is part of the Seamaster professional's identity and not having it would be sacrilege. Whether No Time to Die does Bond any justice or not, this watch will absolutely do it, and I will recommend it for anyone who is looking for a top-tier dive watch that can be a great daily because of its weight and many other things, or if you are just a fan of James Bond, this is absolutely going to be a must-have for you. Thanks for watching today, everyone. I really hope that you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please make sure to smash that subscribe button, give this video a like, and of course, share it with all of your friends. I look forward to seeing you next video.